Hi, everyone, and welcome to the Kellogg Biological Station Long-Term Ecological Research Site, also known as the KBS LTER. I'm here in the main cropping system experiment, also known as the MCSE, lots of acronyms. And my name is Corinne Rutkowski. I'm a graduate student here at KBS, and I'm going to walk you through some of the experiments that we're working on here in the LTER so researchers can examine all sorts of questions in conservation, ecology, and evolution. Let's go take a look. So here we are at one of the switchgrass monoculture plots, and planting switchgrass is one of the more recent changes to the KBS LTER, along with planting prairie strips. And they were planted as alfalfa until 2017, and then were switched over to switchgrass because they're a candidate bioenergy crop. And you can see that now this plot is actually a longer gradient of biodiversity because there's some additional species that have cropped up within the switchgrass monoculture. So here you can see one of our early successional plots, and the early successional treatment is the most diverse treatment within the gradient of biodiversity here at the KBS LTER. And you can see there are several different plant species around. There's some milkweed here that the Landis lab uses to assess monarch behavior and predation. There's some yarrow here, some clover. If you look in the background, you can see some sticky traps that have been set up on T-posts for the Landis lab to look at arthropod abundance. And if you look further back, you can see some of the more woody plant species that have established as well. So two of the treatments within the main cropping system experiment are the reduced input plots and the biologically based plots. Reduced input plots receive just that, reduced levels of chemical inputs like fertilizers and pesticides. And the biologically based plots are effectively managed as organic agriculture. So they don't receive any chemical inputs, and both treatments are planted with cover crops. But you'll also notice something unique about the biologically based and reduced input plots, and that is that there is a zone of prairie vegetation that's been planted down the center of the plots. And this is the first big physical change to any of the treatments that the LTER has experienced in 30 years since the experiment started. Prairie strips are a federally recognized conservation agriculture practice, and they're becoming more widely adopted throughout the Midwest as a way for farmers to reduce soil erosion, to mitigate nutrient runoff, and also to provide habitat for native wildlife and pollinators. And including prairie strips within the KBS LTER allows researchers to study the ecological impacts of prairie strips and ultimately contribute to decision-making around farm policy and agricultural policy. So here you can see one of the prairie strips that has been planted in one of our biologically based treatments. And you can see that the corn monoculture in these plots has actually been encroached by some other plant species. And the corn is noticeably shorter here than it was in the reduced input treatments. So these landscape level differences can have effects on some of the ecological interactions that we're studying here at KBS. So as you can see in the prairie strips right now, there's a lot of wildflowers and forb species that are growing. And that's because the prairie strips are only in their second year. They're just planted in 2019. So we're expecting that as the prairie strips become more mature and established over years 3, 4, and 5, we're going to see a lot more grassy species and a lot less wildflowers. So myself and other researchers at KBS have created a sampling design within the reduced input and biologically based plots to look at the effects of prairie strips over space and over time. So each of these plots includes three transects that runs perpendicular to the prairie strip. So it runs from the prairie strip outward into the row crop in either direction. And this allows researchers to collect samples at multiple distances from the prairie strip. So what are we studying here in the prairie strips? Well, we're researching everything from microscopic bacteria all the way up to landscape level ecosystem services. Some of us are collecting microarthropods and insects to understand how planting prairie strips affects their communities, and other folks are looking at plants that are growing in the prairie strip to understand which prairie plants are establishing and when. So I'll tell you a little bit about the project that I'm working on the prairie strips. So I study soil microbes, and it's obvious that when we plant these prairie strips, we're increasing above ground biodiversity by introducing all these new plant species. But I'm also interested in how prairie strips affect biodiversity below ground where we can't see it. So bacteria and fungi are some of those organisms that live in the soil below ground that play a really important role in agroecosystems. And it's possible that planting these prairie strips actually helps microbes benefit plants, either by mediating their nutrient cycling or also by forming mutual relationships with the plants themselves. So to investigate this, I'm collecting soil from that transect sampling design that I described, and I'm collecting the soil over multiple years so that I can understand how the soil microbial community shifts as the prairie strips become more mature and established, and also as the surrounding row crop goes through a full crop rotation from corn to wheat to soy. So this experimental design also allows me to compare the effect of prairie strips across treatments between the reduced input plots and the biologically based plots. And so far, I'm seeing that the biologically based plots that are managed organically actually harbor more of this mutualist fungi, arbuscular mycorrhizal fungi, compared to the reduced input plots, especially in their prairie strip. And next, we're going to be extracting and sequencing DNA from these soil samples to assess exactly which microbial taxa are living in these plots.